Let us start this grassy shoot of sugarcane plant disease caused by Phytoplasma like organisms. Here, let us see the introduction of this grassy shoot of sugarcane. It is distributed in Southeast Asia, particularly in India. This is the most important disease caused by Phytoplasma like organisms, and it is also considered as a Phytoplasma disease. This disease causes severe damage to the ratoon crops, particularly ratoon means a shoot of perennial plants, but these comes under in this like sugarcane, etc. Phytoplasma infected sugarcane plants that can show a proliferation of tillers, as well as where that is gives it typical grassy appearance. So that is why the name grassy shoot disease has given. Let us see the symptoms. So in this particularly, initial symptoms appears in the young crop that to 3 to 4 months age as thin papery white young leaves at the top of the cane. Later, white or yellow tillers appears in large number below these leaves, and afterwards loss of chlorophyll found in that particular top of the leaves. Premature and excessive tillering gives a crowded appearance like a grass to the clump. In case of the root system, if you could see, the root system has been reduced. Plants shows stunted growth. In Phytoplasma symptom, the stunted growth is one of the common symptom for identification of this disease. This can affected clumps, particularly hardly produces 1 to 2 weeks of the canes. Formation of aerial roots at the lower nodes also going to be takes place. Secondary infection have been observed on the fully grown canes. There particularly shows side sprouting and yellowing symptoms there. And grass like growth at the internodes of the sugarcane we can see. And this has not grown as a healthy plants, and entire stunted growth we can see, and the loss of chlorophyll. The symptomology is common for the Phytoplasma diseases. Casual organism is a Phytoplasma. Candidatus Phytoplasma is very important for the grassy shoot of sugarcane. Here, Phytoplasma cells are physically small, that to it is very smaller than that 1 micron. It was also found, and that they are difficult to detect with a conventional microscope. This is cycle. The pathogen is transmitted by seed materials, particularly. Then afterwards, these are going to be targeted phloem. The phloem feeding leafhoppers are considering as a vectors in the disease transmission. And it is also transmitted by cutting knives and dodders, and that is a root parasite, angiospermic root parasite. We can also discuss that angiospermic parasites in the next classes. So how to control measurements for the measures to controlling this particular grassy shoot of sugarcane disease. So here we have to take care growing resistant varieties, very common. And the roughing of affected stool and destroys. Control of insect pests, because the vectors can transmit the disease very rapidly. So that is why we have to be concentrated in the control of the insect pests. And the crop rotation should be suggested, and seed or planting material should be treated with hot water. That to hot water treatment, it is 50 degrees centigrade for 120 minutes. And the moisture, hot air also going to be produced to that particular field. That is 54 degrees centigrade per hour. spraying dimethoate at 1 ml in 1 liter of water to control the insect vectors. These are about some of the grassy shoot of sugarcane controlling measures. Thank you.